Hi everybody, I'm Elise from the blog LePetiteSaintCrochet.com and I am so excited to be bringing you my favorite crochet basket patterns. There are so many basket patterns out there on Pinterest, and I started looking through because I'm in a super home phase right now. I am organizing, I'm cleaning out, I am going through everything in my house, and I really want things to be beautiful and organized and clean. As I was looking for some crocheted things for my home, I came across some baskets that I really think that you're going to love too. All but one of these patterns is free, and that's what I love about them. They are all great for, I would say, an advanced beginner. There's nothing too difficult about any of them. Also, many of them have video tutorials, which I think is especially great if you are a beginner, but there are the written patterns as well. These are all great designers who know what they're doing, so I cannot wait to share all of them with you. You're going to be able to find links to everything I talk about, from the patterns, to the yarn, to the basket bottoms. Everything is going to be linked down below in the description box. If you've ever been to my channel before, you may know that I typically do not crochet things for my home. I am an amigurumi lover. I usually knit or crochet toys. But how this all came about was I won a giveaway. I never win giveaways. I never win prizes on Instagram, but this time I did. I won a giveaway hosted by Jenna from A Cute Design, and she said I got to pick whatever I wanted from her Etsy shop. So I started looking and I thought, I don't know, what would I want? And I looked through, I saw the basket bottoms, and I knew in that moment, I want to crochet a basket. And I had remembered that Tony from TL Yarn Crafts had used one of Jenna's basket bottoms for her Jenna Stash basket. So I thought, that's exactly what I'm going to do. So she shipped the basket bottom to me and I was so excited to get it. And then, of course, I needed the yarn. This was not my normal yarn, and I ordered my yarn from Knits and Purls. It is t-shirt yarn. We're going to talk about it here in a minute, but I am so excited about this basket. I've got a little secret to tell you about it, and we're going to get to that too. I think it turned out really great, so let's go ahead and talk about all the details. Okay, so I want to go ahead and talk about the elephant in the room. Well, it's not an elephant to you, but it is to me. I messed up on this pattern. I really messed up on it. So if you look at this and you're like, that doesn't look like Tony's or Jenna's, and it really isn't. It's a little bit different. And here's what happened. With this beautiful design, there is a stitch repeat. Now, I got a couple of rows in and I realized what I had done, I lost a stitch, and I didn't realize it until I was several rows in. And by losing one little teeny tiny stitch, it basically messed up the entire stitch pattern repeat, because there's a beautiful pattern repeat on this basket and mine doesn't have it. But you know what? I still think it turned out really gorgeous. I didn't even have the right hook size. I had to use a smaller hook size. I still think it turned out really good. And that is one of the things that I would like to encourage you. Just because you make a mistake doesn't mean all is lost. So now that we got that out of the way and I could just bare my soul about my big mistake I made, I want to go ahead and talk to you about the basket bottoms. They are really, really nice. You can see on the bottom here, there are holes in each one of the places where you put your stitches. It's genius. It's so easy to work with. And what I love about it is that this makes this basket a little more durable, a little stronger, so that you could use it to pack a little lunch with for a picnic, or you could put things in here that really need to lay down solidly and not be bulging down like it would if it was just made from the yarn. So I love these basket bottoms. I can see using them in so many different baskets. They're so beautiful, and baskets are so on trend right now. Just look on Instagram and Pinterest. They're everywhere. People are using them in home decor and for carrying things and for plant holders and all kinds of things. But I love that having the wooden basket bottom makes it so, so easy. They're so affordable. I'm going to leave a link for Jenna's basket bottoms in the description box below, so you'll be able to find one for yourself. And she told me she was going to stock her shop because I know a lot of you are going to want to make this project too. Let's go ahead and talk about this yarn. This is so different from anything I have ever used before. This is called t-shirt yarn, and I really don't even know how to explain it. It's almost like bias tape is the only way I can describe this yarn. It's cotton. It's very cool. It's very soft. It's really, really nice. But when you crochet it up, it is nice and sturdy. I really love it. Now, Knits and Purls has some beautiful choices. I really, really lucked out when I got this little floral design. This has some browns and some greens, and it's on an off-white background, and I absolutely love this yarn. This basket was a bit of a yarn hog. I ended up getting 2 cakes of these yarns because I was a little bit worried that if I only got one, I think this was the 109 yards, and I'm really glad that I got both of them because I was going to run out. I have about 80% of this cake left, which I'm going to make a smaller basket with, so I'm really, really excited about this. Try some t-shirt yarn. It's very, very different. Now, I do want to issue a small, teeny tiny warning. This is 100% cotton. And if you've ever been around here before, you might know that I struggle with some tendonitis in my elbows. And this sort of started to aggravate it a little bit. Using this type of a yarn to make a basket is a pretty decent workout. You really have to... That wasn't very pretty, was it? You do have to dig in there and do your stitches, and it is a little bit rough, and I found it a little bit rough on my elbows, even my wrist a little bit. I had to take breaks. I could do a little bit at a time. It's still a really quick project. It only took me a week to do, and I could only work on it little bits at a time. But I did want to give you that warning in case you have some type of injury, repetitive motion injury. I'll also leave a link for what I have done to help my tendonitis. Sometimes people don't realize that cotton yarn can cause issues because it's a less stretchy fiber than something like wool or acrylic. So I just wanted to give you that little tidbit of information. I will leave a link for that video in the description box below in case you're dealing with some pain from crocheting and knitting. My next favorite basket pattern to share with you is the Tofino basket by Yarn Society. If you have never had the pleasure of going to Katie's website, yarnsociety.com, you're going to need to do that today. She has wonderful free patterns on her blog. She's got a lot of amigurumi patterns on there too that are so adorable. But this is a set of 2 different baskets. It's a round basket and a square basket. It only uses yarn, 2 different colors, so you don't have to have a wooden basket bottom for this one. It really is gorgeous. She said that it... Olive is scratching on me. Come here, baby. You want to be on the camera? Oh, dear, she is. Katie said that it is inspired by a trip to Vancouver, but to me, when I hear Tofino, I was thinking like Italian, like Tofino. I want to say it like that. But apparently, that is Canadian, and it is not Italian. But it is beautiful regardless. I love the neutrals. I love how beautiful that could be as a plant holder or for holding office supplies or in a bathroom. It really is gorgeous.
It's your mommy's skull.
Hi. The next is the Teddy Bear Crochet Planter by Thorsby Cottage. This is from Katie, and you have to go check out her beautiful, beautiful crochet patterns. I love them so very much. And what I loved about this one, yes, it's called a planter for plants, but I could see it being used as a little crochet basket in a nursery or a bathroom or a living room. I don't care where. It is so, so cute. And I love that it combines my love for amigurumi and a basket as well. It is so sweet. It is a free pattern, and I think you are really, really going to love this one too. The next basket is the Herringbone Square Basket Set by Yarn Plus Chai. I really, really loved these baskets. I saw them on Pinterest, and it immediately stopped me. The beautiful photo, and I just love that these are so modern looking. I could just see them being used all around the house for so many different things. It's a great free crochet pattern. I love a free pattern, and I really think you're going to like this one. There's different sizes. It's all made with yarn, and I think they are really, really gorgeous. The next pattern is the Teardrop Hanging Crochet Basket from Sweet Softies. I really loved this one because it was quite unusual. I don't think I've seen anything quite like it before. I love that you can hang it on the wall and you could put little things in there. She has a photo with a little amigurumi animal inside of it, which I think is really cute, but you could put a plant or you could put all types of things inside there. You could even use it in a bathroom with some little towels in there, or in a child's bedroom with toys, or I've heard of these things called air plants, which I've never had one before, but apparently they're very easy to care for and they don't need a whole lot, but you could stick one of them in there. But I love this basket. I love that it's different. I love that it looks so modern. It has that little boho chic look to it, which I think is really in right now. I'm not boho chic, but you know, it's really in with the youngsters, but I think it's really cute and I love that it's also a free pattern. The next pattern is the Crochet Basket Tutorial from Cherry Heart. What I love about this basket pattern is that it is quite simple. Sandra has a great tutorial on her blog for how to do this basket, and I think this one would be particularly good for beginners. So if you have never made a basket, or you're not really sure, you're kind of new to crocheting, this one might be a really, really good one to start with. It is totally customizable with the size yarn and the hook that you have. So I really love this one for that. Also, if you have not checked out her YouTube channel or her blog, she has so many beautiful patterns. She has a wonderful podcast. She's an amazing British lady and I love her accent. Go check that out. I think you're really going to like that beautiful pattern. The next pattern is from Stephanie from All About Ami, and it is the Waistcoat Crochet Basket pattern. And this one is absolutely beautiful. I believe it's the largest one of the group. It is really, really gorgeous. And one of the things that I love about it, number one, it's free, but also that you can customize the handles. So you could either crochet the handles or you could add leather straps to it. And she actually has a tutorial in there for how to do that. It's really beautiful. It's really modern. I love the look of this one. I could see it all over your house for all kinds of things, maybe even adding your crochet blankets inside of there or putting a plant. There are so many things you could do with this pattern. Again, it's free. I do believe there is a video tutorial with this one as well, which is wonderful. So I will leave a link for that one as well in the description box below. The final basket is the Fox Crochet Basket. It is the only paid pattern in all of the ones that I'm sharing today, but I loved it so much I had to share it with you guys. It's a pattern from My Cozy. You can purchase the pattern on Etsy, so you'll find the link for that in the description box below. But I loved this pattern so much. I thought it was so cute. She has it in the traditional rusticky orange of a fox, but she also has it with the gray, like an Arctic fox. It really is beautiful. I could see this as nursery decor. I would use this in my living room because I love animals and I think it's really, really cute, but I could see it in a bathroom. I love that it combines amigurumi and a basket. I think that it's beautiful. It looks like it uses a really chunky yarn, which is really fun, and I bet it whips up really, really quickly. It's got a little bit of changing of colors in there, but I think that it's probably not that difficult to do. I'm gonna leave a link to that basket in the description box below, and I hope you're really going to like it. Olive and I thank you so much for stopping by the Le Petite Saint Crochet YouTube channel today. She looks thrilled to be here, doesn't she? I really appreciate each and every one of you. I really hope that you liked these baskets. I'd love to know which one is your favorite. Leave that in the description box below. As always, if you would hit that like button, that subscribe button, share this channel with people that you think would like to share in the joy of crocheting and knitting. And as always, I will see you all very soon.